Hello everyone,
in this session I will be discussing on numericals of directional drilling. This particular question was asked in GATE 2017. In this question, a directional well has been given. The kickoff point has a true vertical depth of 1000 meter and the end of build-up section has a TVD of 1200 meter. The build-up section for directional drilling has a horizontal displacement of 200 meter, after which the tangent section has inclination of 45 degree. A driller monitors the well from the surface location of the well and sees that the target has a horizontal departure of 1000 meter. We need to calculate the TVD of the deepest point of the well. Alright, so let's draw schematic. So the KOP, the kickoff point, is at 1000 meter. And total horizontal departure is given as 1000 meter. And the build-up section for directional drilling has a horizontal displacement of 200 meter. That means this particular section has 200 meter of departure. All right. And it has also been given that the angle is 45. We need to find out what would be the TVD of the deepest point. Okay, so if this is 45, then considering a triangle over here, so this triangle will also be having 45 degree. Okay, and since now we need to calculate this particular depth, so this would be, if this particular triangle has been considered, then tan 45 would be, let this be L, tan 45 will be equal to L upon 200, so L will be equal to 200 meter. Okay, so this is 200 meter. This particular section is 200 meter. Okay, now coming to this triangle, this right angle triangle, which is present over here. So since this is 200 meter, then this would be around 800 meter. Okay, now again, tan 45, we need to find out this particular section. Let this be the X. Tan 45 would be equal to 800 upon X. So X will be equal to 800. Okay, so the total TVD at the deepest point will be 1000 plus L, which is 200, plus X, which is 800. So final answer is 2000 meter. It's a very simple question. Let's move further. All right, this particular question was asked in GATE 2020. It's a very long numerical. Now let's see how to solve this particular question. So let's look at the question. It is desired to drill a deviated well with build and hold type trajectory. The kickoff point is at a vertical depth of 1500 feet from the surface and the rate of build is given as 2 degree per 100 feet. At a true vertical depth of 7500 feet, the net horizontal departure to the target is 2500 feet. We need to calculate the total measured depth at the end of the target. Okay, so let's first of all, let's draw the schematic. Again, it's a very long numerical. Let's look at the solution. So let's draw the schematic. This is given as 1500 feet. That is, the kickoff point is given at 1500 feet and the total vertical depth is given as 7500 feet. So that gives us this to be 6000 feet. Okay, alright. And it has also been given that the total horizontal departure is 2500 feet. Alright. Let this be the end of build point. Let this be theta. If this is theta, then this will also be theta. This is the right angle triangle. Okay. Alright, so let this be X and let this be point Y. Alright, okay. So very first thing that we need to calculate is the radius of curvature. So my radius of curvature will be equal to 180 upon pi theta. That will give us 180 upon pi. And it has been given that 2 degree per 100 feet. So 2 degree per 100 feet. So my final answer would be 2866 feet. So my R, and this also will be R, so this will be equal to 2866 feet. Alright, okay. If this is 2866 feet and this is 2500 feet. So this the length would be equal to 366 feet. All right. Okay. Now let's calculate angle Y. So tan Y from the triangle. This is a right angle triangle. Okay. So from right angle triangle, if I want to calculate tan Y, then that would be equal to 366 upon 6000 feet. All right. Okay. So my Y will be equal to tan inverse of 366 upon 6000. That gives me Y equal to 3.5 degree. All right. Okay. Now I have got 3.5 degree Y. Now let's calculate X. To calculate X, again, this is a right angle triangle over here. Okay. So taking consideration the geometry, now to calculate X, let cos X equal to, and this is again R, okay, R upon 6000 upon cos of 3.5. yeah, all right. Okay, so my X will be equal to cos inverse of 2866 into cos 3.5 upon 6000. All right, so my X will be equal to 61.5 degree. All right. Okay. All right. So we got X, we got Y. Now from the figure, you can see that my theta plus X plus Y equal to 90. So my theta will be equal to 90 minus X, which is 61.5, minus Y, which is 3.5. So my final answer, that is theta, will be equal to 25 degree. All right. So I got my theta as 25 degree. Now let's move further. Now once I got theta as 25 degree, now let's calculate the measured depth till end of build. Okay, again, this point is my end of build point. Okay, now measured depth till end of build will be equal to 1500 feet plus, now we need to calculate what would be this arc. Okay, to calculate the arc length, we know for 2 degree we have 100 feet. So for 25 degree, how much? All right, so that answer would be equal to around 1250 feet. Okay, so I'm placing this 1250 over here. So my final answer would be 2750 feet. So this is my measured depth at the end of build. Okay, all right. Now to calculate what would be the TVD at the end of build, I would be using 1500 plus, okay, let me assume this particular section as my right angle triangle. Okay, let this be a right angle triangle. Okay, now to calculate my TVD from this, in this particular right angle triangle, so that would be equal to 1500 plus R of sine theta. Okay, so 1500 plus R, again 2866 into sine of 25. So my answer would be around 1500 plus 1211, which will be equal to 2711 feet. So this is my TVD. All right. Okay. So I got my TVD and measured depth at end of build. Now to calculate, now we need to calculate measured depth of this particular section. Okay. For this particular section, I need to calculate. So let me draw this right angle triangle over here. So we know this is 25 degree. Okay. All right. And this length would be equal to 6000. Okay. This will be 6000 minus 1211. All right. So that will be 4789. Now I have this length of 4789. I have this angle of 25 degree. So my cos 25 will be equal to, let this be length L. So my cos 25 will be equal to 4789 divided by L. All right. Okay. So my length L will be equal to 5284 feet. So this is 5284 feet. Plus we have already calculated the measured depth till this point. So my total measured depth at target would be equal to 5284 plus this, plus 2750. All right. So my answer would be equal to 8034 feet. So this is how you get the measured depth at this point at target. Okay, so my final answer is 8034 feet. Again, this is a very long numerical, but once you know the concept, then it will be very easy for you guys to solve this particular question. All right, now let's move further. Now, in this particular question, you need to calculate the horsepower delivered to the bit from the mud motors. Okay, so it has been given the torque of 50,000 pound feet and speed of rotation is 60 revolution per minute. Again, we know the formula of power, which is equal to T cross N upon phi 2 phi 2. Okay, so on placing the values, my answer would be 571.2 horsepower. All right, all you need to do is to remember this particular formula and remember also take special attention of the units. Okay. Alright, now let's move further. Yeah, let's look at the question. The planning procedure for the build and hold trajectory is best illustrated by considering the following example. The KOP is given as 2000 feet. My TVD of target is 10,000 feet. So this leaves me, so this would be 8,000 feet. Horizontal displacement of target is 3,000 feet. Okay, it has been already been drawn. And build up rate is given as 2 degree per 100 feet. Alright, so we need to calculate the drift angle. We need to calculate the TVD and horizontal deviation at the end of build section, and we need to also calculate the measured depth at this target point. So very first thing that you need to do is that you need to calculate the radius of curvature. Okay, all right. So my radius of curvature will be 180 upon pi theta. So that will be equal to 180 upon pi into 2 upon 100 feet. So my answer will be 2866 feet. Okay, so if I'm drawing this radius of curvature, so my radius of curvature will be like this. Okay, this will be 2866 feet. Alright, okay. And so this will be equal to 3000 minus 2866. So this will be equal to 134 feet. Okay, alright. So let this be X and let this be Y. Alright, so this would be my right angle triangle. Got it? Okay. And again, we know this will be the drift angle or theta. So if this is theta, then this will also be equal to theta. Okay. Okay. Now, very first question that we need to address is to find out the drift angle of the well. Okay. For that, let's first calculate tan X. So for tan X will be equal to 134 upon this length. Okay. This is 8,000. We have already calculated it. So tan x will be 134 upon 8000. So my x will be equal to 0.96 degree. All right. Okay. So I got my x value. Now let's calculate y. To calculate y, I am considering this particular right angle triangle. Okay. So sine y will be equal to, again, this is my radius of curvature r. Okay. So sine y equal to r upon 8000 upon cos of 0.96. Okay, so I've just simply used the geometry over here. Okay, so my sine y will be r upon this hypotenuse. Okay, this hypotenuse. So this hypotenuse, the length of the hypotenuse will be equal to 8000 upon cos of 0.96. Okay, so my y value will be equal to sine inverse of 2866 into cos of 0.96 upon 8000. So y will be equal to 20.98. okay, so I got my y as 20.98. now that leaves me, if this is 20.98 and this is my right angle triangle, so this will be equal to 69.02. all right okay, so again, this is a right angle triangle. If this is 0.96 and this is a right angle triangle, and as we know, the sum of all the angles of a right angle triangle will be equal to 180 degree. So this will be obviously 89.04. all right okay, now from the figure only you can get that my theta plus 69.02 plus 89.04 will be equal to 180 degree. Okay, so my theta would be equal to 21.94. Okay, so 21.94 is my theta, so that is my drift angle. So this is how you calculate drift angle. Okay, all right. Now let's address question B, which is the TVD and horizontal deviation at the end of build section. For that, let's look at the procedure. Calculate a point B, that is, let's calculate first measured depth at the end of build. Again, this point is my end of build point. Okay. Now, to calculate measured depth at the end of build, we know it will be equal to 2000 plus the arc length. Okay. Now, to calculate arc length, we know that for 2 degree, we have 100 feet. So, for 21.94 of drift angle, how much? Okay. So, this value will be equal to 1097. Okay. So, total measured depth will be equal to 3097 feet. Now, to calculate TVD at the end of build. So, for that, again, it will be 2000 feet plus this length. Okay. So, let's assume this would be a right angle triangle over here. Okay. Let's assume this would be a right angle triangle. So, by using this geometry, so 2000 plus r of sine theta will be taken into consideration. Okay. So, that will be equal to 2000 plus r, again 2866, of sine of 21.94. Okay. So, this will be equal to 2000 plus 1070. So, my final answer would be 3070 feet. Okay. So, I got my TVD and measured depth at the end of build section. Okay. Now, the final part of the question is to calculate the total measured depth. Okay. We need to calculate total measured depth at target. Okay. All right. So, let's consider this particular triangle over here. I'll be considering this triangle. Let me plot this triangle over here. So, my theta, again 21.94. Again, now we need to calculate the length over here. Okay. So, we know the total length from the kickoff point to the target is 8000. Now, to calculate this particular length over here, it will be equal to 8000 minus of the TVD over here. So, that will be 8000 minus of 1070. Alright. So, that will be equal to 8000 minus 1070, which is 6930 feet. Okay. So, this is 6930 feet. So, this hypotenuse will be equal to cos of 21.94 equal to 6930. Let this hypotenuse be length L. So, my length L will be 7471 feet. So, I have this length L of 7470 feet. Length L of 7470 feet. Plus, I have measured depth till the end of build. So, my total measured depth will be 7471 plus 3097. Okay. So, my final answer would be 10568 feet. Alright. So, this is how you calculate the total measured depth at this point of target. Alright. Okay. So, that's all for today. Hope you all have got the concept behind solving this particular question of directional drilling. Thank you and Jai Hind.